Hi, I'm Robert J. Johnston Jr. I usually go by Bob, and we're at Johns Hopkins University, Department of Biology. So my lab works on developmental biology and gene regulation. In particular, we study how the retina develops. In other words, how the part of the eye that actually detects light develops. And we study this in two main systems, the fruit fly and the human eye. The main question we have is how do the color detecting photoreceptors, how are they specified? So what we're looking at here are two pictures. This is basically what the lab studies. On the left, this is the fruit fly eye, and you can see the two main types of color sensors, the blue and red cells. And on the right, this is a human eye that we've grown in a dish from stem cells. Normally, we think about developmental biology as being very reproducible or the same. So in other words, if you look at your two hands, they're pretty much mirror images of each other. And that tells us that there's a program there. What's different about the human and fly eyes is that these color receptors are randomly distributed. So you'd imagine it's like each cell randomly flips a coin. And if it's heads, it'll be the red type. And if it's tails, it'll be the blue type. So we're trying to figure out how that works in terms of gene regulation. How does a gene randomly decide to be on or off? For me, my love for science has grown over the years. Sharing my ideas with my students in the lab.
So the main spinal library, that's the same universal primer, or that's the original primer from?
It's the same universal primer.
Having that opportunity to mentor people and kind of develop a research program instead of just a project by myself has been really an awesome experience so far. And my philosophy with mentorship is to try to invest a lot of time and training up front and then slowly kind of pull back and promote their independence.
I have a color differently than normal.
I'm still at the bench, so meaning I usually come in and I actually do a lot of work with the fruit flies that we work with. I call myself a facilitator within the lab, so meaning that I am the fly technician. So I'm doing a lot of crosses, I'm generating a lot of genetic combinations of flies that the students in my lab can use for their experiments. So we're tapping the flies out onto the pad to knock them out. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take a look under the microscope and pick out the males and females that I wanna work with. I think any job has to be the perfect fit for a person. And for me, why I love this job, there's many reasons. One is it really challenges me. I inherently like problem solving, and that's what science is you're trying, there's a biological problem and you're trying to figure out the rules. And biology is so hyper complex that figuring out those rules, sometimes it feels like, you know, walking through mud and you're sinking and you're trying to grab onto something solid. But when you do, that's an exciting part. When you do find something new and exciting, you know, that's a great part of it. I mean, that's why I love science, but that's not all of it. You know, I really enjoy mentoring a lot. I really enjoy my interactions with my students. The grad students and the undergrads in the lab have really achieved a lot and have really provided a lot of high points for the lab already. In the short time that I've been a professor, I've seen my students develop, and that is really exciting to see them grow as people.